Now, what is the main effect of the atmosphere? Well, you learned it when you were a kid. Twinkle, twinkle, little star. How I wonder what you are. What is that twinkling? It's called scintillation. Scintillation is a property of a point source, which is a star is so far away, even though they're enormous, they still only subtend a zero-dimensional, almost zero-dimensional dot of light on the sky. When it goes through the atmosphere has macroscopic turbulence features. The atmosphere is a fluid. There's turbulence, there's roiling columns, there's cells of the atmosphere. And if you've ever looked at a star, they jitter, they looks like they're moving around. And that's the combination of the atmospheric cells. Each column of air that has slightly more density will refract light slightly different angles. Remember we talked about light when it goes through a lens, it refracts, it bends.
So should we be thinking about the light from stars kind of like a jagged line coming
exactly.
towards our eye?
It's coming through, it's getting deflected slightly, and it's moving in, and it's landing on different retinal cells. And we're perceiving that as this motion, or in a CCD array, it's also landing on different pixels. So you can't get away from it, you know, by using technology. It's still an effect. It's caused by these atmospheric turbulent cells. And by the way, you can tell and you can identify a planet by the fact that it does not scintillate. It does not twinkle, twinkle. When you look at the planet, you can identify them by their lack of scintillation. And so it's a way to identify if it's a plane, a star, or a planet.